Today, or this time, we are going to do one of the most classical pattern for engraving, which are the bouquet. Of course, it's going to be a bouquet with a twist. And let me show you what I did so far. Me focus a little, just a little. You don't need to see that much. Okay. So that's the bouquet. I've been starting already because I didn't think you really care to watch every little bit of it. Anyway, it's going to be a bouquet which is going to be there, and here are the leaves which are in gold. And here is a little piece of gold for my other leaf. And the flowers themselves are going to be in plain steel. The heart of the daisy are going to be in gold. And it's going to be raised. So it gives some more volume to the thing altogether. Of course, some flower are in a foreplant, and some other are in a background. The one which are in a background, anyway, I will show you when I shade it. I mean, it's just a question of shading. And it's the same thing with the leaves. The leaves are basically underneath the bouquet themselves. So they need to give the impression to be there. Right now, I am still removing the background like I have done here. I know it's not the most exciting part of the engraving, but since it needs to be done, I will show you a little of it. I mean, there is no big secret there. I mean, it's pretty common, and I've done it several times on cam already, but I'm sure that you never get tired of CB work. Anyway, yes, seeing other people work is so much more interesting. So now I'm going to take my faithful chisel and I'm going to start. Let's see if you can see something. Yeah, you see something. Actually, I'm not going to do that. Now I'm going to remove the background because I will have to stipple at some point and I don't really care to do too much of it at once. So let's do that for a few minutes and then I will let you go and I will show you again every so often to see how I am moving along. Don't see much so far. Move it a little like that. Know that some other people who do video feel like accelerating. Video is actually a good way to show what people are doing. I don't agree with that. I mean, even so, my video are always very long. They nevertheless are just a fraction of the time it takes to do it. And I figure that if I take the time to make the video, and if you take the time to watch it, it's to try to learn something. Or maybe not to learn, but to get some idea how it is done. Of course, I could try to sing, but I'm not sure you would enjoy it all that much. I'm not sure that my commentary is all that great either, but I hate when I watch a video on YouTube and people say nothing. Of course, there's not much to describe, as it is self-describing. And you take a flat chisel and I remove the background. So what has to give a third dimension to the engraving? After doing that, I will stipple it. And since it's going to be black, it's going to give the impression to be even deeper. Engraving is basically an optical illusion. I'm sure that you understand that I do it especially well when you are watching, and as soon as I will turn the video off, nah, actually I'm kidding. There's really no way to make it faster. Some people are using etching. I just don't know how to do it. And I don't know if I would like it. I think I get more control that way. Especially when you do inlay in addition, because if you do an etching, of course you get silver or the gold. It's not going to be touched by the etching. But the way the etching is done, basically, there is a mushrooming. It means that the line or the spot that you etch is going to get wider as it gets deeper into the steel. Like a mushroom. And it's especially obvious online. And I suppose that people who do that actually take care of creating their design and function of the limitation of the technique. Oh, the wrong chisel. Let me do it just a little longer. I don't know if I did mention it, but that stuff which is whiter here is silver. I try to keep my stuff clean. So I'm going to use my Bouquet tool. En français, in French, you call it an échoppe. It's basically the same tool than the Italian one. But, no, there is no but actually. It is basically the same tool than the Italian one. It's just that, of course, Italian, the name of the tool is also the name of the technique. Okay, I'm almost done for now. See, I didn't hold you too long with that part of the thing. But I will come back to it, of course. Okay, you can see it's pretty clean actually. And of course, after a stipple, it's going to look much more even. Anyway, that will be all for now, and I will speak to you or entertain you again later. I'm back. Okay, I've been moving forward. That's the part I was showing you earlier. I did now finish to do the background. I removed it and I stippled it. So I'm going to show you a little the way I did it. Another part. I hope you can see that fairly well. Okay, let me move it a little. Okay, I do that in two step. Step one is going to look more or less like this. Let me blow it up. Maybe you will see better. I don't know if you see it much better, but I try. This part is much thinner than this part. This part is very rough. That's a two-step process, as I was saying. So at first I do a very rough stippling, and then I go back to my rough stippling and I thin it out. Why I do it? Because when you remove the background, it's never completely flat. I mean, there is some ridge, there is some part which are higher than some other. And you got some line. Some of them are actually fairly deep. I mean, not in that space, but sometimes they are. So I'm going to show you the way I proceed. I will turn the microphone off because it's a little noisy and it's not really pleasant to look to hear it. But I am going to do this part, which is not too big. And I will start with the roughing out of the stippling, and I will stop when I'm going to move to something a little thinner, so you may see the difference. Okay, now I'm going to do stage two. And a little overexposed, but there is nothing I can do about that. As you can see, the background is already much darker. And as you could see, I didn't put any painting or anything like that. It's basically the natural way it's going to look, which makes sense because basically you are creating Small edge, small angle, and when the light is reflected, it's not reflected toward you, so it looks dark. If the light was reflected toward you, it will look bright. See a little like it does here. See, it's a little brighter here. Okay, now I'm going to use my finer tool to kind of make the background more even. Okay, I am back. Oh, microphone is very low. Let me put it higher. I hope you can hear me better now. Anyway, as you can see, I just finished that part here. There. And as you can observe, I hope, if you compare it to this part there, that part here is much rougher than this one. And when you look at it, when the thing is going to be finished, it's going to look more even and less rough, which is basically what I want. And if I blow it up, that's the maximum I can blow it up, you, I think, can really see that this part here is much softer than this one. Anyway, that's what I feel about it, so since I'm doing it, I must be right. I'm going to finish what I'm doing, and I will go back to you when I was to start to do the shading. The part with the shading is going to be much, much longer, because that's what really I want to show in that video. I have finished now the stippling, and since I am sure that you are dying Yes, absolutely. Dying to see the final result. Here it is. Okay. All right, look. Okay, I suppose. Oh, the picture is really not very good. Let me try to focus a little more. That's as good as going to get. Anyway, that's the way it is. Let me turn it a little so you can see the other side. And now that I did satisfy your very intense curiosity, let me go to what was really the purpose of this video, which is a shedding of the flowers and the liver on the flowers, of course. Don't worry, I'm not going to show you all the flowers. I suppose you got other things to do with your life. But I'm going to do at least the rose, which is there, and maybe this and that daisy and the few leaves around. I am going to start with the leaves around. I was checking to make sure that you actually see something. So here you go. I need to get a little closer. I am going to do something I should have started with actually. The shading here is a fairly heavy shading. That leaf is in the background, obviously. So if I make something much darker around, I will give a much better impression for people, for viewer, to be able to understand what I'm doing. See? I'm going to finish the rest of my flowers. Now, I'm going to do something here. So I'm going to remove that thing there. Okay. And now, I'm going to finish my leaf. Like so. Sorry to be so quiet, but basically there's nothing to say. I'm going to do I don't see anything anymore. Come on. I'm sorry about that. Try to turn the light down. Suppose it's as good as going to get. Try to. Come. Okay, now we are going to do that one. Because this one is coming from underneath that one. So it's going to be shed there. I'm going to shade a little here. finish it completely. I need to do a little here too because it's coming from underneath. Now I'm going to shade the leaf itself. Now I'm going to do a daisy. Let me show you. Where is that? So I'm going to first, I need a cigarette. By the way, I didn't mention it, but I do take a donation in kind. So right now I'm smoking some Winston Red short. So please feel free to send them. And I like Sulawesi coffee. So should you feel the urge? Okay, let's do the daisy now. Basically, a daisy is also in the background. That one is a foreground. So I'm going to start the same way that I did start with the leaf. But it's still a little easier with steel because you can actually see the shading more easily. Using precious metal is kind of interesting because it gives some color to the engraving. On the other hand, silver, gold, even copper are kind of soft. So it does wear much faster than steel. See, just like that, it already give a better impression that the daisy is in the background. It's not a very delicate shading. Just the only purpose is to create the illusion. Okay. Now we are going to shade the daisy itself. At the very end, I will do something with the daisy. But if you want to see what I do, you will have to wait the end of the video. I think it's kind of cool, actually. If I may say so myself. And I can. I just did. This shading look much better defined on steel. And on the silver. I was in Belgium. I'm French, by the way, but I was in Belgium for a few years to learn engraving. And one of the complaints of the Belge about Italian engraving is consider that the Italian was just scratching. And they did not quite understand that actually Italian remove material, just very little of it. And I don't know if you can see it, but if you can, this stuff here is actually metal, because obviously don't cut it. But it's much smaller than there. And do something like that. See, that's a little too out of proportion. So I'm going to make it completely black. I'm going to finish the shading. Okay, that's it for the daisy, at least for now. I will completely finish it later. I'm going to start with the rose now. Actually, that part here, I can just hold on. I was saying I can do something like that. Anyway, we'll do something like that all around that spot. I don't really want to make it black for no special reason. Okay. kind of like a point of light. Could have kind of checker it. I don't know if it's a proper word actually. But I think it's going to create a bit of dimension illusion that way. Sorry. Nothing's okay like that. Okay, now I'm going to do this one. You did see, I'm sure you did notice, I left a white space there, because that one and this one are going to be shed all the way. So I wanted to be able to differentiate between the two petals. Okay, let me do one or two more petals, and then I will interrupt the video, and I will come back at the end, because the one which are larger petal, I would say, not going to be shed more or less over the same way. Actually, I'm going to do that one now. Okay, one last one. Okay, that's all for now. I will go back to that part of the video when I'm almost done with that flower. Enjoy the break. Okay, I've moved forward. Now that almost the end of it. So I'm going to show you this type of petal and the way I shade them. They were almost done.
fine, yeah.
Hello, darling, how are you doing?
Hey, how are you?
Thought I would show you the bouquet. I almost finished shedding the flower, and I still have to shed the leaf around the bouquet, of course. But I'm going to do that in a minute. I'm not playing, I'm trying to focus that thing, and I should say that I'm not fully satisfied. It doesn't work the way I would like for. Anyway, that is a bouquet as it is now, and I'm going to do the shedding of the leaf now, and I will show you when it's done so we can start to do the shedding of the leaf around the bouquet itself. See you then. As you can see, I've been working on the surrounding ornament, but I forget to do the little flower, which are right here. But let me show you how it looks now. I may even focus it. Okay, so I am going to do this three flower there, and then I will show you what I will do on the other side. I am going to start with the heart of the flower. I cannot find my hammer. I did find it. So I'm going to do the heart of the flower. Let me blow it up. Kind of need to know to see at least. Maybe not to know. As to why I use that tool to do the heart instead to just cut it, it's because that tool is actually moving metal, so it's going to kind of polish the surrounding and make it stand a little better. Like that. Simple enough. Let's do the other one since I am at it. Let's do the last one. Yeah, of course you don't see anything, but neither do I. Okay. seem to be all right that way. Now I'm going to do the petal of my flower. First I'm going to finish the center of that, I mean not the center but the periphery of that one. And I'm going to do the shading first on the outside of the flower, which is in the background, which is of course that one. And the one which is in the forefront is this one there. That line that you see here is not a defect, it's because there is a trigger plate, and the trigger plate is inserted into the receiver, and you got that line. It really cannot be helped, but we can try to hide it a little. Like that. Come on. And we're going to do a little thing to the pedal, something like that. And now we can shed it. Thing that I could do and I forgot. That. I'm going to do it and get between the trigger plate and the receiver, because it might make it far more difficult to remove the trigger plate. And if you are wondering what is that nut coming from, it's because I actually use a hammer, I don't use any type of power tool. Actually, it's not quite true. I use power tool when I do the background. Not because it's faster, but just because it's much nicer. In Belgium, they sell some tool to do the background and to do it evenly. But these tools are handmade. And basically, there is no one to do that same type of tool here. So, since I cannot do it myself, I use what is available. And I should say that it's actually working as well or better than what they sell in Belgium. I'm going to go back a little to the center, and that's a toothbrush. It appears to be almost like a ball like that. I think I'm going to use my Bolino tool to do the rest of the shading. By the way, in Belgium, what they call in Italy a Bolino tool, it's not called a Bolino tool, it's called just a Bolino. In Belgium, it's called an échoppe. I did that one a little big, but it's okay. Flower do not need to be symmetrical. And since I am a tit, I might as well do that one too. To do a little thing like that. And a little thing like this. I'm going to do the same thing in that one. Now we can do the shading. Of course, since I do the shading with this tool, it's going to be a little more delicate. I forget to shed that leaf earlier. So I can do it now. That's the way I look. Thing from other way. Having some problem to focus today. It's not a bad reflection. It's slightly curved, so not sure it's any better. Anyway, I am going to do the other side now. We are going to do it together for a little while, and I will finish it on my own. Okay, let me explain to you. I'm sure you don't need it, but I love the sound of my own voice. Here, oh, I forgot to do the stippling there. Oh, let me do that. I'm going to let you hear it for once. I'm sure you appreciate now that I usually turn the microphone off. Okay, I'm not going to do the flower, which are its round stuff right there. I'm going to do the leaf right now. Going to use my chisel. I need to sharpen my tool a little. I'm sure you're going to see a tremendous difference. And of course, sometimes you can actually mix what tool you are using. Actually, I did tell you earlier that I was using hammer and chisel. I know that a lot of people really like power tool, but what I like about hammer and chisel is the fact that you can actually hear what you are doing. What I mean that if I go very deep, I will have to hit my hammer much harder, of course. And you can really hear it. And I think hearing it can be a very good guide. Of course, being French, I could justify the most stupid thing I'm doing. See, I mess it up here a little. Right here. So I'm going to take my magic tool and bend back to stay where it belongs. Now I'm going to shade some of the leaves which are part of the bouquet, but not all of them. Because for example, that one is so small that if I start to shade it, it's going to become too black and it would not be distinguishable from the background. But these three there are much larger, so I can actually do a little shading. I know it has been a very long section already, but I'm going to do that one because that one is a little different from the other. Okay, I think that's been enough. I will get back to you later after I finish the shading all of this thing, and I will show you the final result. That will be it for that video. Bye for now. At last, we are at the last stage on this thing. So I'm going to show you what I do at the last stage. I think you might find that interesting or even amusing. Let's see if I can find the tool which I need first. I will use another one. Okay, I'm going to create a gold heart to my Daisy. She's going to have a gold heart because she's very tender. Come on, it wasn't that bad. I'm going to show you. Two of them, maybe. Hope you won't get too bored. But if you do, you can always turn up. Okay, now I need a piece of gold. That one is going to fit my purpose. Yeah, I'm looking for something, of course. Here it is. I'm going to put my little ball. Is that a ball? I'm sure you do. More or less in the center. I'm going to put it more or less in the middle, like so. And my ball was a little too big. I'll try to make the next one a little smaller. Almost there. And try to clean it a little. We're getting there. Need to do it one last time. Et voilà, isn't it cute? Can even do a little of that. So it will shine. Okay, I'm going to do that one now. And this time I will put a little less gold. So it will be easier. I'm not sure it's any smaller, but I tried. Yeah, I'm almost there. They will have to do. And here we got the second one. I'm not going to show you all the other one because I'm sure you are going to get bored. And that one looked pretty good actually. It gave a very nice impression of deepness of the petal going toward the center. I'm going to do the other two. And the one there I'm going to leave alone because I got this one is on both parts, this part and that part. And of course, if I was to put a piece of gold in the middle, I would be in trouble. So I won't. But on this side, I did not do any shading, and I'm going to put, I think, some silver instead of gold to make it somewhat different. Or maybe these three are going to be in silver and that one will be in gold. Yeah, that seems to be like the way I'm going to do it. I will show you the final result. Stay tuned. Okay, here are the final result of my effort. Let me try to give you a little more light. I don't know if it makes that much difference. But anyway, that's the way it looked like. And I decided not to go with gold heart on the little flower there, because I didn't feel like it. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Take care. Bye-bye.